in our country, it's always and. It is the good and the bad. It's always both, and it's living in the tension.
This is part of a larger project to connect scholars worldwide. And it's part of the program that the Council for Christian Colleges and Universities in the United States began back in 2008. We're eager to make connections to get North American creators looking at where the cutting edge of so much of God's work in the world apparently is going on. So places in Africa and Asia and Latin America.
Go to Liberty Park and see some of the different monuments and memorials that were there. One of the things was an area where different stones from all over the country were placed in a circle. Just seeing that and seeing the way that they did it was really meaningful and very reverent.
Interested in using art as a form of resistance. So how can works of art resist the sorts of political oppression that we're practicing all over the world? At one of the museums, they were talking about how there's always an angle that's not being addressed. There's always a story that's not being told. And so I think I'm always interested in finding that empty space.
I really enjoy seeing how artists think. I listen to social scientists, even though I'm more on the humanities side, and how do you fix it up? And they're saying, how do you express the joy and the pain that we're seeing?
Sort of like a different perspective to how do I observe art, how do I see art that sort of like have history in it, also sort of like create hope in it. I mean, it also changed the way I think, how should I show art, how should I engage with people with art, how should I speak and send a message through art.
Cultural exposure has been great. The historical exposure has been really valuable.
We went for a visit to the Apartheid Museum. When I came out, I was very emotional and great.
We went to Apartheid Museum. I mean, it was an amazing experience. I started to see South Africa in a different perspective, especially digging in the history of South Africa. I mean, it was amazing.
it was hard for me. It was really hard to sort of face up to the past. I knew I sort of had to have mental preparation to say, okay, you're gonna see things and deal with things which you don't necessarily want to.
One of the highlights has to be visiting Diane Victor's studio. Here is someone who creates art for the express purpose of saying something pointed and prophetic about contemporary life. It was remarkable to behold her passion and her ingenuity.
I really want to change the world, oh, I really want to sing your song, oh, but I know revival's got to start with me. I really want to change the world, oh, sing your song, but I know revival's got to start with me. You're my revival song. You start where I belong, on my knees, on my knees. With me.